My favorite extracurricular activity this year has been doing tours and panels for the admissions office, really because the crowds come out for me. I get to bond with mom and dad, and all the kids want to be like me someday. And I get to tell great stories about my life, about how I heard John McCain speak here at BC, how I heard then Senator, now President Barack Obama speak here at BC, how he waved to me in the stands. There was eye contact, there was a connection. So really, a lot of great experiences here at BC, and able to give it to the little high schoolers that want to come to BC.
So the most worthwhile extracurricular I've done at BC would have to be Synergy, Hip Hop Dance Company. I was director this year, so just like getting to like control the group and like, I don't know, it was just really cool to like be in the know and like lead the group in like a certain direction and like watch people grow from like where they came in as freshmen to like where they are now in terms of like dancing as people. And we're just like a tight, fun family, and we like to just entertain people. So.
It's been great being on BC cross country and track and field teams. Met some of my best friends here at BC. It's been fun just competing for another 4 years. It's been great just being in the ACC, I guess. It's almost, I guess, the highest level of competition there is in collegiate athletics. Josie's on a vacation far away. Come
around and talk it over. So many things that I want. I just love the proximity and not having to wait and take a bus every day, especially in the winter when it was cold. And I don't know, people from Newland said they had like a sense of community, but I think Upper had a sense of community as well. I really liked it. I made friends with all the girls on my floor.
Well, I'm the Newland representative here. A lot of what they say is true. There's a really strong connection between people who grew up in Newland freshman year. You see people around campus even this year, 4 years later, and you recognize them and you say, oh, I know you from somewhere. Most likely the connection is Newton. I lived in North Keys, so I was the Newton of Newton, so we didn't really talk to anyone else. But, you know, still today I can call them up and they'll hang out, and it's not weird at all. So
I lived on Upper. I was in Fenwick, and Newton I'm sure was nice, but I thought it was really nice to live right on campus. You're a few feet away. With you. A few feet away from mid-campus, which is really nice. You know, roll out of bed 10, 15 minutes before class. You don't have to worry about getting on a bus and waiting for buses. When it came back to, you know, going out at night, the mods are a couple of feet away as well versus having to take a 2 o'clock bus home. I don't know, I loved it. Also, a lot more people live on Upper versus Newton, so it was really good.
Tailgating usually happens, it's legally happens 3 hours before the game, but here at the Mods, if we have a game, we're usually up by 8 a.m. blasting this great song called Peach by Peaches. Once we're all dressed in our superfan shirts, we're usually hanging out with Sophie here. Sophie, say hi. Sophie is our flabongo. You flip Sophie over and pour a beer, and then you take it out of her mouth.
Being an RD this year for the class of 2009 has been great. They're a really wonderful class, and they do lots of fun things, and I get to be part of it, so it's nice. I think this class has been able to keep a really positive mindset, even with not so positive outlook after graduation. And they've had a lot of fun throughout the year just with football and the mods and Marathon Monday coming up.